Good evening and welcome to Sensual Talk. This is the place where we talk all things sensual, tantalizing, and delicious. I'm your host, Emanuela Fernandez. As many as 43% of women and 31% of men have experienced sexual dysfunction. One of the most common problems is low sex drive. So tonight, let's talk about how to nourish your desire. With me tonight is a good friend of mine and registered holistic nutritionist, Andrea Sinclair. Thank you so much for being on Sensual Talk.
Well, thank you, Emanuela. I'm really looking forward to this.
And we are at your home and you even prepared a little spread for us. So I'm so grateful for that.
Well, it's all about food, isn't it?
It really is at the end of the day. And I mean, like we were just talking a little bit earlier, it is such a sensual experience and it also nourishes you. But today we're going to talk about something just a little bit more serious because it is a very big problem. I mean, statistics don't lie. It is a big problem. Sexual dysfunction. Many of us experience low libido, low desire. So tonight we're going to talk about how we can nourish those things. So once again, thank you very much for having me at your home. It's beautiful in here.
Oh, well, thank you so much. Thank you.
But of course, it wouldn't be Sensual Talk if we didn't have a little glass of Prosecco tonight.
Exactly. I chose Prosecco for the bubbles because it's all about tantalizing the senses, right?
Oh, you're talking my language here. Thank you for that. And also, it makes things festive. So thank you very much. And it is a festive thing when we get together with friends,
right? You're right. At the end of the day, I think it's really important just to have fun with things. Don't take it too seriously.
Absolutely. Andrew, I'm going to ask you just for the sake of I'm going to ask you just to scooch in a little bit.
Sure, absolutely.
Closer to me. I mean, you know, we're friends and all, you know, and we hug and all of that.
Right.
So, so just for the sake of framing. So thank you very much. Anyway, so many things to get to. I really hope that you can stick around. Lots of things to talk about. It's an important topic. You know, we appreciate all of your comments. And I also want to give a shout out to Dronish Media for sponsoring us tonight, just like every other night. We really, really appreciate it for making this happen. And like I said, it's an important topic. Lots of things to get to. So let's begin. You are the wealth of knowledge. I can't wait for you to share your expertise. But you, as a registered holistic nutritionist, I want to get your take on why do people have such low sex drives?
That's a really good question, and I do see it a lot. I really do. It's I think it's something we struggle with today. It's partly all the stress in our lives. It's just, you know, we're so hectic. We're so focused on so many other things, so many demands on our life. And really, as a holistic nutritionist, I don't just look at food. We look at the whole lifestyle in and around that as well. And I think part of the problem is that our food is really in bad shape these days. We're just not getting the nutrition that we like, that we need, or the way it was, you know, 50 years ago or even 30 years ago. So we just have to be extra vigilant. But that being said, we can still have fun with it as well. Now, I think part of the problem, it's a whole combination of things. We've kind of got the perfect storm as well. We're struggling with hormone issues, and it's interesting. When you look at a lot of men, you hear a lot on the TV about erectile dysfunction and low T. And if you look at what doctors and the medical establishment, they're really focused on this low testosterone. Actually, from a holistic point of view, I think it's really important to also look at the estrogen levels, because I think it's not just so much an issue of low T, as too much estrogen in our systems these days. A lot of the toxicity out there mimics estrogen, and I think we all know that chickens and various things are plumped up with estrogen. So most of us just have way too much estrogen in our system, and it's wreaking havoc with women as well, not just men, but definitely with men. I personally think it's really, really important to be careful about what you eat. It's so important to eat organic. Most of the food here is organic,
and
we'll get into it in a minute. But I think also you it's important to cleanse every once in a while. And so I help people with that, and I've seen real things really shift. I can't tell me how many times I've talked to someone and they said, you know, my spouse thinks I'm a much nicer person now.
Wow.
It just shifts everything.
I need one of those too. I gotta go on a cleanse. Wow. Well, it's really interesting what you're saying, because it's true. Our environment and what we eat has so much to do with mm-hmm. the way we feel at the end of the day, right? And it's not surprising that such thing as our libido is also affected. And I mean, we all know that there are some other mm-hmm. issues that really may be rooted in deeply,
yeah.
right? Like depression or anxiety. Or for some people, it may be, you know, past sexual trauma. So those things certainly need to be treated by a therapist.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. But Emanuela, you hit on a really interesting topic, because I don't think most people realize how much our brain chemistry is affected by what we eat. So certainly trauma is something that would need to be dealt with by a professional. But there's a lot that it can be done to address depression, anxiety on a nutrition and a food level.
Right. So another problem that so many of us struggle with. I want to talk about, how do we actually nourish our sexual desire? You know, because that was
yes.
the kind of the topic of tonight's show. And I
yes.
think that's what people are expecting for us to talk
exactly.
about. So how do we nourish? How do we give our bodies what it needs in order to have that
exactly.
sexual libido
mm-hmm.
striving?
Okay, well, in the background, of course, is all the things that I've talked about in terms of making sure you've got a healthy body, healthy brain chemistry. All these things are extremely important. But one of the things I really love are the issues in and around food that really, you know, because food is so sensual. It is such a wonderful part of our life. And I think a lot of the time, we just sort of grab something, eat it out of a package, and we've lost all the sensuality of the food. It's so important to be looking at food from a sensual point of view, and by that I mean really touching all the senses. So it's important to have it visually looking nice. I put together here some smoked salmon on a cracker.
May I?
You absolutely help yourself. And there's avocado there rather than use something more decadent. This is actually something that's fairly healthy. And my point being, you can have something delicious. It looks beautiful. It tastes beautiful. The avocado is very sensual. It's just got that creaminess, and it just adds to the cracker. And yet it's pretty healthy on the whole. And I think too, over and above that, just the very effort put into it too says something to your partner about, I really care for you and I really want to make this effort to do something beautiful that you will really love. I mean, it's not just about peeling grapes. You can do so many other things as well. And then I also have here, I brought us dessert as well, maybe after you've settle down a little from the salmon, you might try one of these. These are chocolate cranberry clusters that I made just for the show, actually. And
they're delicious.
They've got chocolate in them, which actually is a really healthy food. It's got all kinds of antioxidants. It's wonderful. I think women especially respond to chocolate on a hormonal level as well as a physical level, and just the taste. And so I'd be happy to give out these recipes as well. I'm happy to send the recipe for the chocolate clusters, and
fantastic.
Maybe give out my email address at the end.
Absolutely. And you must try them at home, because, you know, it's really, really decadent. And I mean, chocolate does help with production of serotonin.
Absolutely.
Which is our happiness hormone, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, it's wonderful for us when we do feel happy. You probably notice that even your sexual desire changes, right?
Yes,
it really shifts towards a much more active state.
Yes. I was going to get into serotonin as well, but also in these, I've got coconut oil, coconut, and there's
so
some
delicious.
Maple syrup, which has wonderful minerals in it too. And the minerals are something that we're really depleted in our diet. And actually, when we are depleted in minerals, women are low in serotonin.
And so we're happiness hormone.
Yeah, basically. And it also, when you get enough serotonin, without serotonin, the proper levels of serotonin, women are kind of on edge. They can't relax. It's kind of like you have an endless to-do list. And then if you get enough serotonin in your system, it just, you can feel that everything's relaxed and kind of all is well with the world. You don't have to jump up and do something. Mm-hmm. And I think that sense of jumping up and doing something wreaks havoc when you're trying to be with somebody on an intimate level.
Right. And that's the issue, I think, in all aspects of our lives.
Yes,
because
yes.
We have all of those to-do lists, right? And it doesn't leave us time to bond with our food, like you said, you know, that time for it and space for that wonderful sensual eating. We don't have time
exactly.
for that.
And I bet most people don't realize that that's actually a nutritional issue. It's not psychological necessarily. It's actually fundamentally nutritional.
Right. Well, one interesting thing that I actually heard recently is that it's so important for us to smell our food.
Oh,
because
absolutely.
What actually happens is our mouths are producing certain
mm-hmm.
enzymes, right, that
mm-hmm.
make us salivate. And actually when we're salivating, right, after smelling food, we digest it better.
Exactly. That's a really good point. And also, in terms of smelling food as well, they say that is the strongest sense attached to memory as well.
Yeah.
So it means we really respond emotionally to smell. It's a really big.
So think of something as simple as erection, right? I mean,
mm-hmm.
there has to be lubrication happening for a woman, right? And there has to be erection happening. So it's the foreplay that probably evokes that, or whatever it is that works
mm-hmm.
for you, right? And that's when we're able to engage in intercourse.
Yeah.
So it's the same thing with food. So make sure that you smell your food. Make sure
mm-hmm.
that you really, really engage all of your senses. Take time with your food. Really engage
yes,
in that
exactly.
sensual foreplay with your food. And I think your body is just going to be so much happier. And I mean, we can actually turn it into a fantastic foreplay. And think outside the box. I mean, don't
That's
just
right.
think of
you
whipping
don't have
cream.
To eat off the plate.
You don't have to. You really don't have to. But I mean, you can really experiment with things like, you don't necessarily have to only stick to things that are known as classic foreplay ingredients, like, let's say, whipping cream or chocolate or strawberries. I mean, like I always say, you know, watch Mickey Rourke and Kim Basinger in 9.5 weeks. I mean, that's the ultimate sensual foreplay.
Yeah.
Absolutely
yeah.
phenomenal.
Yeah.
Is there anything else that we need to know when it comes to nourishing our desire?
Yeah, I think I should backtrack. And we talked about women and serotonin. Actually, with men, if they're low in minerals, the issue is dopamine there. So what happens is if a man's low in dopamine, he tends to kind of come home and crash on the sofa because he needs to kind of rejuvenate, you know, after a long day. And so if men get enough dopamine in their diet, there isn't quite the need to do that. They have more focus, more concentration, just more energy to devote to life and, of course, devote to engaging with their partner.
So how do men get dopamine?
Well, one of the best ways is through increasing the minerals in their food. That's absolutely important.
Okay.
Yeah.
Fantastic stuff, Andrea. I can't thank you enough. And that all of this food is just speaking to me.
Yeah.
I can't wait to indulge more. But
I just realized I should probably clarify minerals. Minerals, really, we get through our plants and through our plants.
Mm-hmm.
So, because the minerals take the minerals from the soil and break them, they're broken down into something we can ingest. So, may not be the most popular idea for men, but more vegetables and fruits definitely will help.
What does steak do? Like, does steak provide
protein,
anything?
Protein, it's great for muscle building, absolutely.
All right, so you don't have to give up steak, which
no.
is great.
Well, that's what I believe. It's everything in moderation.
Right.
So I know a lot of people, when they, you know, get into nutrition, they're real sticklers about every aspect of it. But you I think at the bottom line, you have to have fun with food.
Absolutely. So true. And I mean, food doesn't have, we don't have to be so serious about it.
No, and it's about socializing. So it's incredibly important to sit down with your partner and share food. That is so important. And with your family, of course, too. But it is just really, really important. And in this day and age, I think we've lost a lot of that.
So true.
Yeah.
Now, from a holistic nutritionist perspective, What does Prosecco do to you?
Or that's any kind of bubbles wine. And fun.
And really, like we said, that's what sensual eating, that's what food, that's what engagement, that's what it's all about. So, Andrea, I can't thank you enough.
Oh, thank you, Manuel. That was a pleasure. I very much enjoyed it.
So excited to dig into all the food that you prepared. And
let's do that.
I want to thank you all for joining us tonight for another episode of Essential Talk. You know, so many things to think about, so many things to take away. I really hope that this is going to act as an invitation for you to start a wonderful sensual eating, sensual living, sensual love-making journey of your own. I hope that this just simply inspires you to start leading much healthier, happier, and much sexier lifestyles. So thank you very much. I also want to give another shout out to Dronesh Media for sponsoring us tonight. And Andrea couldn't be happier. Thank you very much. Thanks for joining us. I'm Emanuela Fernandez. We'll see you next time on Sensual Talk. And let's finally have a sip, shall we?
Yes.
Mm. That was a big one for me. All right, that's a wrap. Great.